Praise God. Well, it's good to be here again in God's presence today. Now, I put a video out yesterday, and I'm afraid it was faulty because it was a music presentation called The Golden Road to Heaven. And when I put it out there and I played it, there was no soundtrack on it because it's supposed to be a soundtrack at the back, but I took it off, I deleted it and uploaded another one. So if you watch that, there's no soundtrack. If you want to go back, you'll hear the soundtrack. Thank you. I just want to take a reading from John. On the video, this reading is on that particular video. It's John chapter 14, verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And then Jesus went on to say, because Thomas asked him, but we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me. Here's the only way to God. Here's the only way to heaven, Jesus Christ. And so that's in that music presentation. And then you'll have to watch it to hear the rest of it. So, but I was we were singing a song. And I was singing this song here, and it's called Mansion. And I just want to read these words to you today. There is a mansion in heaven where the King of Glory dwells. There is a banqueting table a father and his son have prepared, where angels bow and elders throw their crowns. All the beasts of the field and the birds of the air will shout, fill this house with your glory, Lord. Fill this place with your praise. Fill this house with your presence, Ancient of Days. There is a mansion in heaven where the King of Glory dwells. I come to the banqueting table that the Father and his Son have prepared. I bow down and throw down my crown. With the beasts of the field and the birds of the air, I will shout, fill my life with your glory, Lord. Fill my heart with your love. Fill my soul with your presence. I can't get enough. And that's what it's all about, isn't it? The Christian life. It's all about following Jesus. And Jesus said he's gone back. He's gone to heaven to prepare a place for him. He's coming back. He's coming back soon. And so at this point in time, we are disciples of Jesus Christ. All those who are trusting and obeying his commands and walking in the Spirit are disciples of Jesus Christ. And he's taken us on a journey through this life. But remember, we have eternal life. And one day we're going to walk right into heaven. And we're in the presence of God now. We're going to see the face of Jesus Christ. He's coming back. And the Bible says we shall see him face to face. But at this point of time, some of you are going through trials in your life and you don't know what's happening and you're finding it very difficult. But I just want to read some more scriptures to you, because this is also in the soundtrack. Basically, this is the gist of the soundtrack, the storyline, and it's all about this really. But I just want to emphasize it today. What is happening? What is happening in your life for those that are struggling? It says in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. He's alive. Praise God for that. That's why we're kept by the power of God, because it goes on to say, he's been raised from the dead, we're kept by the power of God, and we've been raised to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you. You know, that's a great thing about this inheritance that we have. When we invest our lives into Jesus Christ and our service for him, we're investing in heaven's bank. And the thief and moth and rust can't get in, breakthrough and steal and corrode. It's kept in heaven for us. And so when we see Jesus, our inheritance will be waiting for us. And so we have the earnest of our inheritance now, the divine deposit, the Holy Spirit in our hearts, the Spirit of Christ, and we're born again. But there's a lot more to come. So keep on following the Lord, no matter what you have to go through. He goes on to say here, who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Remember, it's all by faith. Keep your faith in Jesus. In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials. Grieved by various trials, or distressed by various trials. That's what it means. That the genuineness of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honour and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen you love, Though now you do not see him, yet believing you rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls. And so, you know, trust in Jesus, because something is happening. In the trial, God is working something out in your life. In the trial and through the trial, you've got to trust God, because he's doing an inner work. You know, he's making us more like Jesus. And you won't see that work. You won't see many changes in your own life. Others will see more than you see. But God sees far more than anybody else can see. And on that day when we stand before Jesus Christ, if you've followed the Lord faithfully, been a disciple of Jesus, and you've allowed the Holy Spirit to do his work in your life through the trials and tribulations that you go through, you're going to see the genuineness of your faith. You're going to say to yourself and to others and to the Lord, it was worth it, even though I suffered. You know, trials aren't pleasant. There is suffering in the Christian life, whether we like it or not. Anybody who says there's no suffering in the Christian life, then really, I question whether they're really a disciple of Jesus Christ. But let me just finish with this word here. And this word here is also in that music presentation, The Golden Road to Heaven. Malachi chapter 3, verse 17. For those who have followed Jesus faithfully, you'll stand before him on that day. This is God's word to you. They shall be mine, says the Lord of hosts, on the day that I make them my jewels. Isn't that a wonderful thing? He's making us, he's polishing us up, you know. He's getting the rough edges off our lives and making us more like Christ in our inner man. And one day we'll see what kind of jewel we really are before the Lord. He will make us his jewels. Thank you for listening today. Keep following Jesus. Trust him through the trial. He'll get you through. You won't be in that position all the time, but you will go through those times in your life. But that's all for the good. That is for your benefit. Praise God. It will be worth it. Thank you.